How old Captain Gerald is?
That's enough, Leonie. If I don't know, how could my child know?
It's not normal to forget your own age, you know. It's kind of worrisome, actually.
By the time you're forgetting your own age, you're past the point of caring.
I guess if you put it that way, you've got a point. Hey, I hope we get a chance to practice together when you find the time. I know I'm in a different class, but you're the only other person here who's learned from Captain Gerald. Professor, hey!
I have a request.
In the mock battle was exceptional, Professor. You have inspired me to follow your example and study even more diligently. Perhaps we could train together sometime. I would love to test myself against your sword skills again.
I hear you've been tasked with hunting down bandits, right? Meanwhile, my class is stuck with a downright peaceful mission. Sounds like you'll be fighting alongside the knights, too. Don't let the monastery down, Teach.
That reminds me.
A moment, please.
Hey there.
Let's see. That person sure does remind me of somebody, but I can't figure out who. Oh, do you need me for something? Sorry, but I'm really busy right now.
The Iyer family, we have long held the position of Prime Minister in the Empire. The Empire's power lies with six noble families, my family foremost among them. The full explanation may be time-consuming. I can give you a moment to get ready, if you would like to take notes. All right, I will list the six great noble families. There is Caspar's father, Count Burgles, the Minister of Military Affairs. Then there's Linhart's father, Count Hevering, the Minister of Domestic Affairs. Bernadetta's father, Count Varley, is the Minister of Religious Affairs. Hubert's father, Marquis Vestra, is the Minister of the Imperial Household. Finally, we have Duke Gert, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, and my own father, Duke Iyer, the Prime Minister. One day, I will take his place as the Prime Minister of the Empire. I am more talented than anyone in my class, even Edelgard. I will lead the Empire to a bright, enlightened future. There is nothing I cannot achieve.
Hey! Inside the cathedral, there is a chapel dedicated to the four saints. Do you know of them? Saint Indec, Saint Macule, Saint Keyhole, and...
Saint Cethlene! Who is your favorite, Professor?
Now that you are a member of the Church, be sure to familiarize yourself with our teachings and traditions. I have something to ask of you.
Is nice and quiet. It's so relaxing. Oh, Professor, did you come to pray to the goddess? Me too. Shall we pray together? Oh, you want me to join your class? I'm already having so much fun in my current class. Sorry to disappoint, but I'll have to decline. For some students, this will be their first time stepping onto a real battlefield. It's important that they're mentally prepared. As for me, do I look green to you? Is there anything else you wish to ask me about regarding spending your time at the monastery or battles? Just as students have much to learn from other students, professors can also share their knowledge with each other. You should consider seeking instruction from Professor Hanneman or Professor Manuela. I think you'll find their insight quite interesting. Which house a student is assigned to depends on where they're from. That said, each professor has their own area of expertise. So if a student is adamant about it, it is possible to switch someone from one house to another, pending your approval, of course. If you become closer with the students by partaking in the various activities around the monastery, you'll be able to talk to them about such things.
I fully accept the necessity of real battle from time to time. But it is still a surprise to be tasked with punishing bandits without warning. It is a rather different sort of mission. It makes me wonder what the Archbishop is planning.
Xanadu, the Red Canyon, is a place of great significance to the Church of Saros. Even members of the Church are forbidden from entering without permission. To go trampling around in there, causing trouble. Those bandits truly are morally reprehensible.
Is there anything troubling you? Or is there, perhaps, something I can help you with? You seem to be getting along well with the students. I would advise you to be confident in your abilities. The rest will fall into place, and I can often be found here, so if there is ever anything you need, please do not hesitate to pay me a visit.
Hey, you!
Thanks for your help.
Excellent work, guiding and bearing the Unknown Crest's power. Yes, I'm talking about you. Your talents are incredible, and Lady Rhea's insight as to your potential is doubly so.
A sea of countless books, tracking down that single sought-after volume. It's absolute bliss. How do the poor fools who spend their days sharpening swords and polishing armor find any joy in life?
Really? Professor, there are some things I'll just never understand. Like the other night, I went on a date with a dashing, handsome, strong young knight. Oh, I'm a bit weak just remembering him. Anyway, do you know what that no-good jerk said when we got back to my room? He said, "What a mess. I'm afraid to go in there. Can you believe it? You know who cares about keeping everything neat and tidy? Not me, that's who. Afraid to go in there. Some knight he is.
How about this? Do you know about the Cardinals? They're the ones who run the church. Their identities are a closely guarded secret.
Favor to ask. Excuse me. Oh, Professor. Hello. Excuse me. I have to go.
Have we met? No. Sorry. Must be my imagination.
My undershirt got blown away by the wind. And it's not important why. It only matters that it's pale blue. Thank you so much.
So.
Thank you.
savior. Thank you. Down. Don't want people thinking I'm vying for attention. But how loud is too loud?
Professor, let me sing for you. Do you not like my voice? It would make a Pegasus dance with joy.
Even people from far-off lands gather here at the Academy. Word of advice, Professor. There are those who don't think kindly of such people. Professor!
Something else. So,
well done. You have my thanks.
Right.
Here's an idea. Everyone's likes and dislikes, so I know what to cook. Who knows when it'll be my turn at kitchen duty? How about you, Professor? Do you like sweet or spicy food? Ooh, same! I'll definitely remember that. Huh? You think I would be a good fit for your class? I'm not sure. There's still a lot I want to learn from my current class. Sorry to disappoint. This meal. How did you know?
This is my favorite. I am rather happy you went out of your way to pick it, Professor.
Have you not been told what's expected from lectures here? Well, I can tell you how it works based on what I've heard from other professors. Before starting a lecture, it's a good idea to determine everyone's academic goals. Students will want to prioritize studying things that will help them achieve their aim. It's probably easier to get good results if you instruct students based on their interests and specialties. Of course, that doesn't mean it's pointless to teach someone things unrelated to their personal goals as well.
By looking beyond their preferences, some students may find they're interested in fields they've never previously considered. A student's goals may change based on their studies or the experience they gain while on missions. When that happens, perhaps you could help them decide what new goals they should set for themselves. How motivated a student is will affect how well your tutoring goes. To help cultivate their motivation, I think it's a good idea to interact with your students as much as possible. Please try your best to motivate everyone, so that they, in turn, will try hard with their assignments and activities. At the Officers Academy, students are encouraged to engage in various activities in and around the monastery. If you instruct your students to work together as a team, it will help to deepen their bonds and produce better results. Have you heard about the certification exams? They take place every month. Everyone here is working hard to become a certain type of soldier, and those tests are how you can check to see how far we've come. In order to pass the exam, you need to train enough to become whatever class you're aiming for. Take care to develop your students strategically so that they can pass their certification exams. I still have much to learn. I still have much to learn.
May I be asking a question? You have great wisdom. Ready to get some work done?
Oh, no. This is impossible.
We did it. Now.
Thanks.
In battle, it's necessary to deploy battalions so that students can experience taking command. I doubt I need to say this to a mercenary like you, but if you have any questions about how to use your soldiers, please don't hesitate to ask. After you hire a battalion, you'll need to decide who will lead them. Battalions can contain soldiers like mages and monks who don't fight with weapons. Be sure to think carefully about who would benefit most from the support of battalion soldiers and their specific skills. When you deploy a battalion, you can utilize its special gambit in battle. Successful, your enemy will be severely shaken. Joining forces with a nearby ally is a surefire way to enhance your effectiveness.
Could have at least tried.
Sweet of you.
I have held back? Each battle, a chance to grow. Another step forward. Dead. I guess hard work does pay off. I will not be stopping. As expected. Failure is not an option. Can I go now?
Miss Bridget Pride. Hard. Didn't give it your all. Each battle, a chance to grow. We must all do our part.
Perhaps I've been well taught.
I'll keep my voice down. Don't want people thinking I'm vying for attention, but how loud is too loud?
Professor, let me sing for you. Do you not like my voice? It would make a Pegasus dance with joy.
Forget all I've learned.
The battlefield has much to teach.
Seems simple enough.
Not a total waste. Let's put this to the test.
I think I got it. I work to grow.
path to tread.
Perfect timing, Professor. I've just received word from the Knights. They've located the bandits.
It seems they have them cornered. They are in Xanadu, the Red Canyon.
I can't wait to get started. I'll strike down those heinous thieves before they know what hit them.
Charge ahead if you must, Caspar. Just do not put the rest of us in danger.
I'm going back. I won't be of any help anyway, and I don't want to get hurt.
Don't worry, Bern. It's just some bandits. We'll have no trouble at all.
Don't get ahead of yourselves. Unfounded optimism isn't a great strategy. Let's just get this over with.
There is nothing to get over. We will work with each other to achieve our mission.
It's time, Professor. Give us our orders and let's move out.
Are you looking for something?
You could say that. I'm looking for someone named Linhart who's been skipping lectures again.
I see. Well, congratulations, you've found him. Did you want him for something in particular?
What else could bring me here other than your complete negligence?
Well, perhaps you're interested in hearing my latest theories on the nature of crests. I suspect the formation of crests may be quite different than that recorded in church tradition.
Before you go on, is there any discernible benefit to me allowing this battle to continue?
Well, of course.
And that would be?
I suspect you'll find the topic rather entertaining.
That's it.
What more do you need? Crest research is its own reward.
You know, if you ever truly applied yourself, you could become a distinguished scholar. You could use your crest knowledge to benefit the world, or uncover new discoveries in magic theory.
Why would I busy myself with such tedious work? I perform this research for my own knowledge. I'm not interested in the world at large.
There's nothing wrong with a selfish drive for knowledge, but only if you put it to good use.
I'm sure there must be some use.
Oh? Then please, tell me what potential uses you have in mind.
Well, there are people out there who spend good money on bizarre artistic creations. So I'm sure my not-at-all-useful research could be used as a fine lullaby for the children of the world.
A lullaby? I have things to do. Just know that this was my last warning.
Sure, of course. Goodbye.
Terrible parts of the day just disappear. If only people could be more like flowers. What's Burn doing? She looks like there's something wrong. All these nobles are just terrifying. And the commoners? Just look at Dorothea. So pretty, popular, dazzling. There's no way someone like me could ever be close with someone like that. Burn, are you okay? Dorothea! Did you hear all that? Just the part about you wishing you could get along with someone. So, Burn, who have you got a crush on? Seriously now, you have to tell me. Who are they? Do I know them? I'm so excited for you, Burn. No. I was actually thinking about being friends with you. Me? I thought we already were friends. That's not what I mean. Oh, I'm such a coward. I thought it would be great if we could be closer. But old memories just get in the way for me. Burn, whatever happened in the past, you know you have my full support. I'm here for you. I thought we'd already been friends for a long time now. Please. Just forget it. We'll never be close friends. He would just... No! Wait, I... Father? What did she mean by that?
Dorothea, the dining hall seems so much brighter with you here.
must say, you are quite adept with flattery. Please, give me some more.
Flattery? No, I was not... There you go with that attitude again. Why do you reserve such cold treatment for me and me alone? Do you hate me, Dorothea? Or have you some other reason to avoid my company?
I underestimated you. I assumed your noble upbringing had dulled your perception. But you got it right on your first try. I hate you.
Huh, I was right. Might I ask why you find me so despicable? I can scarcely guess.
Don't waste another minute thinking about it.
That will not do. I do not think you would hate a person for no reason.
Perhaps. How's this? If you can guess why, I'll let you know if you're right. The brains of us common folk are so simple, it should be pretty easy for a big-shot noble to sort out.
Very well. I cannot walk away from a challenge. I have no choice but to chance a guess. You are always making fun, calling me a big shot and so forth. Perhaps you think all nobles are... No, it cannot be that simple.
Oh? What can't be that simple?
Please, will you not give me a clue?
Well, let me see. A good clue? I know. It's because you're like a bee. That ought to be enough of a clue. So long, Ferdy.
A bee? I haven't the slightest. Perhaps because I am such a diligent worker?
So, we are taking children into battle, are we? I am not certain I will be able to sleep soundly after beholding something like that. I shall allow you to turn back the hands of time. But no, this power is not infinite.
This is the Red Canyon, a ruin of sorts by the look of it. Let's end this quickly. The thieves must have been driven back. Be careful, or the cornered mice might bite us.
The knights chased us all the way here?
Chief, let's get out of here. There's no way we can win against them.
Shut your dumb mouth! Where would we go at this point? You can't be a thief if you fear death!
Professor. I hear there's a back road to the west. Why don't we split up and attack from both the west and the front? If we advance tactfully, we can attack our enemy from both sides. I leave the rest to you. Regardless, we must cross the bridge first.
Perhaps I've been well taught.
Well, how was that?
Regrettable, but there was no other way. Should I have held back?
Ahead of myself.
I must get stronger. Prevail. Witness my power.
We stole this treasure. It's all ours. There's no way we're gonna give it up to some knights.
This is our chance.
Lady Edelgard. This strength will serve Lady Edelgard well. Allow me to clean this up for you.